for joining us. When Reba McEntire heard the song, And Still, she knew it was something special, so special that it went to number one a few weeks ago. And the writers were the toast of the town yesterday. Jan Snyder took the opportunity to ask the singer about the music video that visualizes the song so well.
Thousands of people live in this town, and I had to run into him.
This is a song worth celebrating.
It's a great feeling to be able to sing a song where the women in the front row are just wiping the tears away as fast as I can sing the song, and then men are kind of looking off, you know, like.
Yesterday in Nashville, writers Tommy Lee James and Liz Hingber were honored for this finely crafted song.
Congratulations, Liz, and thank you.
The beauty of the song evokes strong visual images, interpreted by director Jack Cole in this music video. The project was shot in Central America, outside Guatemala City.
You know, when you go down there, first of all, it had been a third world country. We wanted to, okay, let's ship them money. Let's ship them pots and pans and appliances and stuff. We figured it out by the time we left. They're a lot happier than we are. They don't have to mess with any of the stuff we do.
In the video, Reba plays a teacher. The extras are Guatemalan school children.
And the kids were sitting behind me, and I said, okay, I'm going to teach you a song. Of course, they couldn't understand a word I said, but the teacher did. And he would translate. And I played, oh, McDonald had a farm. And I pointed to them, and they'd go, E-I-E-I-O. So that was like on a Monday. That's the first day we started filming. And so Wednesday, when we came back to the school, a lot of the kids were different. And but there was this one little girl, just beautiful. You can see her real clear in the video. And she was there Monday, and she was also there Wednesday. And I looked over at her, and I smiled at her. And I remember her from Monday, and she said, Reba. E-I-E-I-O. I said, you want to do that one again? And so, boy, we took into it, and all the kids learned it in that class also.
But it was the Guatemalan lifestyle that really affected the project.
We'd say, okay, now we need the bus here to take the actors over there. See, and maybe tomorrow we'll get it for you. You know, it's just like that laid-back, kickback mentality. They're just that way, and you can't knock them for it.
The folks in Central America may be laid back, but Reba sure isn't. She's celebrating her 20th year in the business with a new album due in October. Reba's updating her autobiography for the release of the paperback.